Hi, welcome to Enchiridion. I'm glad to share with you these facts on Metriorhynchus. Metriorhynchus was the marine crocodyliform that lived in the oceans during the Late Jurassic. The type species Metriorhynchus brevirostris was named in 1829 as a species of Steneosaurus prior to being named as a separate genus by the German paleontologist Christian von Meyer in 1832. Metriorhynchus is one of the better known marine crocodyliforms with features that show it was more at home in the water than on the land. The legs have evolved to become more like flippers, and the tail sports evidence of a tail fluke. It is likely that this tail provided primary locomotion in the water, with the legs being used for maneuvering. One strong piece of evidence to suggest that Metriorhynchus spent most of its life in the water is the presence of salt glands. Salt glands are found in numerous marine animals and work by extracting excess salts from the blood so they can be excreted externally in a concentrated form. By having an active gland constantly removing salt from the blood, marine creatures including Metriorhynchus would have been able to drink seawater as well as eat other marine animals that would have had a higher salt content than land animals. It is not known for certain if Metriorhynchus spent all of its time in the water or if it returned to the land. On land, Metriorhynchus would have been more cumbersome, as evidenced by its marine specializations, but it too may have had for special tasks like laying eggs, just like turtles do. While other marine reptiles like ichthyosaurs almost certainly gave birth to live young, it needs to be remembered that these evolved from different lines, and that Metriorhynchus had more immediate terrestrial ancestors, meaning that it may not have had enough evolutionary time to develop live birth at sea. Although an active predator, there is also evidence for Metriorhynchus scavenging on animals like plesiosaurs, suggesting an opportunistic lifestyle. In turn, Metriorhynchus may have been preyed upon by larger predators, like the short-necked pliosaurs, including Pliosaurus and Liopleurodon, that swam the oceans at the same time. Other well-known Mesozoic marine crocodiles include Dacosaurus, Geosaurus, Plesiosuchus, and Turbonustes. Fossil specimens referable to Metriorhynchus are known from late Jurassic Cambrian deposits of France. Only one valid species is recognized today, the type species Metriorhynchus geoffrey, now called Metriorhynchus brevirostris. Metriorhynchus hastifer and Metriorhynchus palpebrosis are generally distinct from the Metriorhynchus type species, with hastifer being recovered as a geosauriny. Species in this genus were traditionally classed into two skull groups, longirostrin, or those with long, narrow jaws, and brevirostrin, or those with the short, broad jaws. Nonetheless, most brevirostrin species have been transferred to the genera Puranosaurus and Sacodus. Metriorhynchus superciliosus has recently been shown to be distinct from the type species Metriorhynchus brevirostris, and now has its own genus, the Thalattosuchus. The genera Puranosaurus and Sacodus have been considered junior synonyms of Metriorhynchus. Nonetheless, recent phylogenetic analysis do not support the monophyly, or common ancestry of merely Metriorhynchus as conceived of in the 1960s to 2010. In 1867 and 1869, Udi's Long Champs recognized four Colobian species of Metriorhynchus: Metriorhynchus superciliosus, Morelli, Blainbelly, and Brachyrhynchus. Later, in 1913, Andrus considered there to be seven valid species: Metriorhynchus superciliosus, Morelli, Brachyrhynchus, Durobrebensis, Cultridens, Leedsi, and Levy. However, in 1987, using linear morphometrix, Adams-Tresman could only distinguish between the two skull groups, so she discovered there to be two species from the Oxford clay: Metriorhynchus superciliosus and Metriorhynchus brachyrhynchus. Nonetheless, in 1997, yet another change was made, with Bignod considering there to be three Colobian species: Metriorhynchus superciliosus, Brachyrhynchus, and Leedsi. Fragmentary remains attributed to Metriorhynchus are known from South America during the Bajocian and Bathonian, both in the Middle Jurassic. In spite of that, phylogenetic analysis has shown that these species cannot be referred to Metriorhynchus. Metriorhynchus means moderate snout. It is derived from the Greek metro, meaning moderate, and rhynchus, meaning snout. It was named by Christian Erich Hermann von Meyer in 1830. It belongs to the kingdom Animalia, the phylum Chordata, the class Reptilia, the suborder Thalattosuchia, the family Metriorhynchidae, the subfamily Metriorhynchidae, the genus Metriorhynchus and the type species Metriorhynchus brevirostris. Synonyms include Cicotis, Gavialis jorini, Metriorhynchus geoffrey, Streptospondylus geoffrey, Steneosaurus brevirostris, and Steneosaurus rostral minor. Species include the type species Metriorhynchus brevirostris. It was a carnivore, possibly feasting on squids, shellfish, and other fishes. It was 9.8 feet or 3 meters long. It has been discovered in France, Europe, though possibly also in other locations. It lived in the Colombian-Akima region of the Late Jurassic 157.3 to 152.1 million years ago, and fossil representation includes many known specimens. And with that, thank you for watching. Thank you to the people that pointed out a minor inaccuracy in the Sarcosuchus video. Sarcosuchus wasn't a crocodile, but in fact a crocodyliform. So thank you for pointing that out. Recently, the Goblin Shrek video surpassed 4,000 views, so that's great news. Yet since the creation of this video, it has surpassed 5,000 views, which is even better. I'm just very excited to make a lot of very high quality documentaries on prehistoric beasts and dinosaurs. As always, thank you for watching. This is Enchiridion. See you next time.